nice, full of niceness. Now, as you may have guessed, the theme is the ocean, the sea, and I've been so happy to see so many gorgeous sea creatures. If you're holding a sea creature, or if you're next to someone holding a creature, or if you're in the same room as someone holding a creature, a sea creature, just go, ooh. So, I'm going to start with a little serious bit. It always starts a little bit serious. This is a bit from a poem about the vastness of the ocean. Because my theme tonight, ladies and gentlemen, and octopuses, is the spangly vastness of the ocean. This is a little bit from a poem called The Choice by Dante Gabriel Rossetti. Nay, come up hither. From this wave-washed mound unto the furthest flood-brim, look with me. Then reach on with thy thought till it be drowned. Miles and miles distant, though the grey line be, and though thy soul sail leagues and leagues beyond, still leagues beyond those leagues, there is more sea. And so now that you can all breathe underwater, because you can, you know, that's just the thing. My second little thing is going to be a Gaelic song called Firavata, and it's all about longing to see someone again and hoping that they'll come back across the ocean. I think especially in the beautiful Gaelic language, it sounds just like the sort of thing a mermaid might sing. I'm going to sing it in the Gaelic language, but I'll give you the gist of what it means now. I climb the waves and search the ocean. Climb the waves and search the ocean. Will you come, love, when the night falls? Or will I turn homeward, weeping? You can be a pufferfish quite easily by doing that, or you can also become an octopus quite easily by doing that. But I don't need to tell you that, you knew that already, so here we go. But Henry had a problem, now guess what that might be? For Henry was a friendly fish. Hello? You're right? Deadly as can be. Bye then. he swam around alone. He only had one special friend to talk to on the phone. Jeremy the octopus would call him every day. He loved that little puffer fish. And this is what he said. Henry, you have reached a point when something must be done. You never go to parties, you don't have any fun. You're right, he said, oh Jeremy, I knew that you would see. Although I am a puffer fish, there's so much more to me. Jeremy the octopus said, Henry, you must go to a cave beneath the ocean that no one else will know. I know it won't be easy, but you have to make a start beneath those deadly spikes of yours. You have a gentle heart.
Which is true, it was a nice fish, I met it.
Now he's going to go down past the harpsichord, and yeah, that's more like it. Now in this spooky cave he found a massive piece of rock. He swam around it cautiously, he wasn't fond of shock. I wonder what I'm doing here, how I can reach my goal. This is my fishy turning point. My dark night off the shore. Suddenly he realized exactly what to do. He rubbed himself against the rock all day and all night through. The morning sun shone down upon the strangest sight of all. A shiny little puffer fish with no more spikes at all.
Yeah! He's having a lovely time. Of course, he's completely vulnerable to predators, but we won't talk about that.
He frolics in the ocean, he's the toast of the Barrier Reef. When interviewed on radio, he's witty and he's brief. I'm glad I had that lonely time when I was down at heel. Whenever I see a spiky fish, I know how he must feel. But you know, it's not such a bad time to thing to have time on your own. You know, you learn a new skill. I mean, he learned to play the trumpet. You may laugh, you do not believe me. Is always by his side. His happy transformation fills the octopus with pride. He used to be unpopular, but now he has a ball. A friendly little puffer fish with no more spikes at all. Now, I'm going to introduce you to, how should I put this, two colleagues of mine who've become friends.